Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this official exercise, we are going to determine the differential equation that governs the variation of x and then verify the solution of this equation, determine the expression of the natural angular frequency omega zero, determine the expression of the oscillation amplitude xm, match each curve to its corresponding energy in the energy versus time graph, determine graphically the relation between the oscillation period and the period of energy, determine graphically the launching speed of the trolley.
Consider a small trolley C of mass 200 grams, attached to one extremity of a horizontal spring R of negligible mass and of force constant 20 newtons per meter. The other extremity of the spring is attached to a fixed support A. The trolley C may slide without friction on a horizontal rail, and its center of mass G can move along the horizontal x-axis. At time zero, G is initially in its equilibrium position O, so x equals x of zero equals zero, and is given an initial velocity V0 equal minus V0i, where V0 is positive, and then C oscillates without friction with its natural angular frequency omega zero. Take the horizontal plane passing through G as a reference level for gravitational potential energy. Number one, write at an instant t the expression of the mechanical energy of the system C, R, air in terms of m, k, x, and v. The mechanical energy is given by kinetic energy plus elastic potential energy plus gravitational potential energy. Since the horizontal plane containing G is taken as a reference level for the gravitational potential energy, then GPE remains zero. So ME is equal to 1/2 mv squared plus 1/2 kx squared.
Let's move to part 2, derive the second order differential equation governing the variation of the abscissa of G. We said in the question that friction is negligible, then the mechanical energy is conserved. Also, we can say that the sum of the works done by the non-conservative forces is zero, therefore the mechanical energy is conserved. The expression of the mechanical energy is found in the previous slide. Now, if the mechanical energy is conserved, then its derivative with respect to time is equal to zero. Now, we need to differentiate this expression with respect to time. Let's start with 1/2 mv squared. 1/2 m is constant, v squared is variable. Then, the derivative of v squared with respect to time is equal to 2vv prime. Similarly, the derivative of x squared with respect to time is equal to 2xx prime. The 2 and the half cancel out. So this is going to be mvv prime plus kxx prime. You know that x prime is equal to v and v prime is equal to x double prime. So let's replace x prime by v and v prime by x double prime in the above equation, and then we will take v as a common factor. We will get this equation. Now this equation has two solutions. The first solution is v equal zero, but this solution is rejected because in reality v is equal to zero only at the extreme positions. Let's move to the second solution. Mx double prime plus kx is equal to zero. Divide the equation by m. This is going to be x double prime plus k over mx is equal to zero. This is the differential equation.
Part 3. The solution of this differential equation is of the form x equal minus xm sine omega 0 t, where xm is a positive constant. 3a. Determine the expression of the natural angular frequency omega 0 in terms of k and m. Using the solution or the time equation, x is equal to constant times variable. So the derivative of x with respect to time is equal to the constant minus xm times the derivative of sine omega 0 t. And the derivative of sine omega 0 t is equal to omega 0 cosine omega 0 t. So x prime equal minus omega 0 xm cosine omega 0 t. Similarly, x prime is equal to constant times a variable. And the derivative of x prime with respect to time is equal the constant minus omega 0 xm times the derivative of cosine omega 0 t. And the derivative of cosine omega 0 t is equal to minus omega 0 sine omega 0 t. Therefore, x double prime is equal to omega 0 squared xm sine omega 0 t. But xm sine omega 0 t is equal to minus x. So x double prime is equal to minus omega 0 squared times x. Now replace x double prime by minus omega 0 squared x in the differential equation, then minus omega 0 squared x plus k over mx is equal to 0. Take x as a common factor. So x into minus omega 0 squared plus k over m is equal to 0. This equation has two solutions. The first solution is x equals 0, but physically x cannot be 0 as a solution, because if x is equal to 0, we have no motion. So the acceptable solution is minus omega 0 squared plus k over m is equal to 0. Therefore, omega 0 is equal to the square root of k over m.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's move to part 3b, deduce the value of the natural period T0. In the previous slide, we found the expression of the natural angular frequency. We know that the natural period is given by this expression, 2 pi over omega 0. Replace omega 0 in this expression by the square root of k over m. This is going to be 2 pi times the square root of m over k. Now we are ready to calculate the natural period. The mass is equal to 200 grams, which becomes 0.2 kilograms. The force constant is equal to 20 newtons per meter, and the natural period is equal to 0.628 seconds. Let's move to part 4. Determine the expression of the amplitude xm in terms of v0, k, and m. We have the expression of x and the expression of x prime from the previous slide. In the beginning of the question, we said that at time 0, v is equal to minus v0. Let's move to the expression of v. Replace t by 0 in this expression. We know that cosine 0 is equal to 1. Then v at time 0 is equal to minus omega 0 xm times 1, which is equal to minus omega 0 xm. Therefore, v0 is equal to omega 0 xm. Now we want xm in terms of v0, k, and m. But here we have xm in terms of omega 0 and v0. Then replace omega 0 by its expression, the square root of k over m. This is going to be the square root of k over m times xm. Therefore, xm is equal to v0 times the square root of m over k.
Energetic study. An appropriate device allows to obtain the variations with respect to time of the kinetic energy, elastic potential energy, and the mechanical energy of the system CRR. Part 1. Indicate with the justification the type of energy corresponding to each curve. We know that the oscillator oscillates with no friction, so the mechanical energy is conserved, or ME is constant. Look at the figure. The energy corresponding to curve 1 remains constant, so curve 1 represents the mechanical energy of the system. Referring to the initial conditions, at time 0, x is equal to 0. So the elastic potential energy at time zero, which is given by 1/2 kx0 squared, is equal to zero. Look at the figure again. The energy corresponding to curve 3 at time zero is equal to zero. So curve 3 represents the elastic potential energy. We know that at time zero, EPE is equal to zero. And the mechanical energy at time zero is equal to the kinetic energy plus the elastic potential energy at time zero. So at time zero, KE is equal to ME equal E zero, because EPE at time zero is equal to zero. Look at the figure again. The energy corresponding to curve 2 at time zero is equal to 0.1. So curve 2 represents the kinetic energy of the system.
Let's move to part 2. The energies represented by the curves 2 and 3 are periodic of period T. Part 2a. Pick up from the figure the value of T. In the figure, each of the curves 2 and 3 repeats itself identically during a time of 0.314 seconds. Therefore, the period of the energy is equal to 0.314 seconds. Part 2b, deduce the relation between T and T0. In the previous slide, we calculated the natural period of oscillation. It is equal to 0.628 seconds. But here, the period of the energy is equal to 0.314 seconds. Therefore, the natural period is equal to 2 times the period of the energy. Part 3, write the expression of E0 in terms of M and V0. Look at the graph. E0 represents the initial mechanical energy. The initial mechanical energy is equal to the initial kinetic energy plus the initial elastic potential energy. The initial kinetic energy is equal to 1/2 mv0 squared, while the initial elastic potential energy is equal to zero, as it is shown in the graph. Therefore, E0 is equal to 1/2 mv0 squared. Part 4, deduce the value of V0. Replace E0 and M by their values. E0 is equal to 0.1 joules and the mass is equal to 0.2 kilograms and V0 is equal to 1 meters per second.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button and share.